is called Hello, and it is hands-on early literacy for little ones. It's a pre-reading program for very young children. It teaches them a number of concepts and skills that they'll need. It teaches them sounds of the letter names, rhyming, and of course we pack in all kinds of interesting facts about science, and most of all, fun. Today. We're only going to be going up to L, but we're going to be going through all the letters. What we're going to do first is we're going to say the name of the letter first, and then the next thing is we're going to do the sound, and then we give the animal. Ready? Let's go. A, 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 ant. B, 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 bear. C, 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 cat. D, 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 dog. E, 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 elephant. F, fish. G, 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 gorilla. H, horse. I, iguana. J, 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 jellyfish. K, 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 kangaroo. L, o, lamb. Nice job, you guys did a great job, thank you. Today's letter is A. And I'm going to show you how your mouth is formed to make the letter A. A has the sound of a, a, a. You're going to want to put your tongue touching your teeth, the front, and then you're going to want to go with kind of like a smile where you go a, a, a. Where this letter comes from, you can also feel. Make the sound a, a, a. And you can see that it's in your upper neck up here. That's how you make the sound for letter A, A. Today's word of the day is ant. Let's take a closer look at the word ant. Let's say the letters A, N, T. Those are the letters. Now let's say the sounds. A, N, say the sounds again. A, n, t. Let's slide these a little bit closer and say them a little bit faster. A, n, t. A, n, t. Now let's slide them really close together. A, n, t. Ant. Ant. That's how we say the word ant.
We're going to rhyme the word ants twice. For the first time, close your eyes and listen for that ants sound in the rhymes. And then for the second one, open your eyes and read along. Let's get started.
Ants, ants, wearing pants. Ants, ants, wearing pants. Wait! Ants don't wear pants. The ants chant. Ants, ants, without pants. Ants, ants, without pants. Ants, ants, wearing pants. Ants, ants, wearing pants. Wait! Ants don't wear pants. The ants chant. Ants, ants, without pants. Ants, ants, without pants.
Hi, my name is Miss Karen, and today, for the letter A, we are going to be learning about ants, and I have a special guest. Alexander Ant, and he has a story he's going to tell us all about being an ant, aren't you, Alexander? Yep. All right, let's see what you have to tell us about ants, Alexander. Oh, Alexander, that's a great picture of an ant for everyone. Look at it, turn around. All insects have how many? Three body parts? You've got three body parts and how many legs? One, two, three, four, five, six legs. You are an insect. That's your home? Oh, that's a nice home. But all of that is below. So below the hole, there's tunnels that go all over. That's your home. It's a lovely home. What's below? What is that? Eggs? Those are all ant eggs? That's what the whole ant hill is filled with? We call it an ant colony, and ant colonies are filled with ant eggs, with all the baby. But you don't necessarily take care of the babies. You do something different. You go out and you look for food. You leave the nest and you go and look for food. Oh, that sounds fun. But how do you bring all that food back to the colony? So you take your mandibles and you haul it? How does that work? You haul it with your mandibles? So ants' mandibles don't work like our mouth. Our mouth opens and closes like this. Their mouth goes back and forth. Their mouth will go back and forth and hold on to things. Then when they have it held, it's not like scissors that they can cut. They rip off pieces. So they tear and rip when they have their mandibles. And you can haul anything. Look at the ants work together to haul this spider. The spider is dead. The spider is not moving. It's dead. But you guys take all of your work and move that spider by hauling it, holding it with your mandibles. Whew. Yeah, I would say you need a drink after that. One of the things that's interesting about ants when they drink is they can't drink with their mouths. They don't have a mouth like we do. So what they do is they dip their mandibles in the water. It wicks up, if you can see, and goes into that little opening there and holds there and then sort of drips back into their mouth. So that's how an ant drinks. Oh, what? You've got to go? Where do you have to go? Why do you have to go? Alexander, why are you running off? What are you running off? It's just, an anteater. Run, Alexander, run. Get away from that anteater. He's coming. This is a great book to read for Alexander Ant, and see if you can find the ants that are in this book. They are hidden, but you'll be able to find them because the anteater is near the ants. I hope you enjoy checking this book out and reading it.
This is The Ants Go Marching by the Lori Berkner Band.
The ants go marching one by one, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching one by one, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching one by one, the little one stop to suck his thumb, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 the ants go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching two by two, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching two by two, the little one stop to tie his shoe, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, 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 the ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching three by three, the little one stops to climb a tree, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Marching five by five, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching five by five, hurrah, hurrah. The ants go marching five by five, the little one stops to take a dive, and they all go marching down into the ground to get out of the rain. Boom, boom, boom.
I'd like to give you some tips for things that you can do at home. The first one is for science. That is, go out and see if you can find some ants. It's so important for parents and children to do more observation of nature. It really helps when they're taking science classes because they will have an understanding of how nature interacts and what to look for and what questions to ask. So go out and find some ants and observe them, see where they're going and what they're doing. The next tip I'd like to give you is for literacy. Literacy, the tip I'd like to give you is that when you're reading a book, have your child predict what's on the next page. So as you're reading, rather than turn the page, stop, ask your child what you think might happen next, and predict it. Again, any prediction your child makes is good because it means they're thinking about what the story is about. So all predictions are right. And then turn it off, and then find out what actually does happen. Those are our tips for ants.
Thank you all so much for joining us. Next time, we're going to learn about A for aphids. Now let's all sing our goodbye song.
This is how we say goodbye, say goodbye, say goodbye. This is